Good morning to everyone. My name is Antonio. I'm from
I'm going to introduce you. First of all, I want to thank the Shot Foundation and Shota for inviting us. I will introduce you this model. It's called the CAF model. In Spanish, Comunidades Autofinanciadas. It means self-financed communities. Okay. I never thought that integration of models for low-income people should accomplish four characteristics. The first one is that a lot of times we're thinking about economic integration of the people, but I think we have to focus also in emotional integration. And I think that one of the best ways is through creating relational networks for the people, social networks for the people. And I also believe, as some people from Ashoka said, that I think we have to bring together private companies, the public sector, the academic, universities, colleges, schools, and the social sector working together, because if not, it's like just part of the solution. And another thing I really believe is that we have to think that the low-income people are the main actors of their own development. And we have been trying solutions from up to down. And not only they are the main actors, but they are the ones who can tell us the best solutions a lot of times. We have to observe them, how they do things. I remember I was living in Guatemala, and I needed to buy a bicycle. And I was working with communities there, and they showed me a system that people call it seed fund, I think. Have you heard about seed funds? Yes. They call it in Guatemala cuchubal. This is like Chinese restaurant or Indian restaurant that are all over the world with no franchise strategy. They say it's all over the world, and low-income people do that. For the ones you don't know, it's 12 people who put money together every month, just like kind of lottery, and it goes to someone. So I got my first bicycle with this system, and I remember that I was thinking, that means that there are savings in the community, there's trust in the community, so that's very important to learn about that. So from that experience, and especially because another Ashoka fellow started this model in Venezuela, we created this CAF model. In this model, there are 10 to 30 people, sometimes 40 people. They buy shares and they create a company in the community. Oh, just owned by the people. There's no external money. No external money is accepted. It's just with the money of the people. So they buy shares. It's like a private company. Everyone can buy the shares they want, depending on the trust they have in the community. And this community, this company, the community, gives services to the community. Okay. So they are investing in the community. It's not saving, it's investing in the community. Okay. So this company starts giving credits to the community, very small credits to the community, with an interest rate, of course, that they decide. And they give insurances to the community for emergencies. They give jobs to the communities, charging. But it's owned by the community with the important point that nobody has more than 50% of the shares. So there's no a big owner, but everybody owns with the company, depending on the shares everyone wants to buy. It's important that there's benefit at the end of the year, so people start seeing that investing in the community gives benefits to them. These are some photographs of the groups. This is a group of African people from Senegal that lives in Girona, in Spain. This is a group of people from different countries in Latin America, and also Spanish people. They are working together creating this. This is people basically from Central America. So some results, this is a very simple model, as you can see. It has been expanded to 10 different countries. I think the good thing is that it started in Latin America, then it jumped to it started in the south, it jumped to Europe, to the north, and then it went to Africa. So that was the expansion process. And probably it will go to Asia in a few time. Also answering to this question, another result is that different sectors have been involved. For example, our workers, the people who promote that these community companies are done in the communities, are basically people from universities, and they are paid for that as a traineeship. The public sector is contracting us because they have discovered that it's one of the best ways to bring people together, because there's a high participation of the people, because it's their own money, so they it's a high ownership of the company. Who more? Private companies are participating because they are seeing that there's a potential in the community, and it's very interesting seeing that insurance companies after some years come to the community and say, okay, now that you know how to deal with insurances and you're customers of insurances, maybe you need a bigger insurance. So the community says, okay, a lot of times they negotiate with the insurance company and they say, if we can do it alone, we will do it alone, we don't need you. No. And if we need you, we will tell you, and we will negotiate with you. So it's a different perspective. It's giving a lot of power to the community. In Spain, it has been a very nice experience because we work very much with immigrant people. So it's bringing immigrant people and Spanish people together. Immigrant people in Spain are seen like they are low-income people a lot of times. So there are some very interesting experiences where there are some Catalan people who have not social networks, because in Europe sometimes we are like economically development, but socially we're not very good in social networks a lot of times. We are a bit unhappy in those things. So a lot of immigrant people are teaching us how to work in community. So it's interesting to see how immigrant people are integrating Spanish people in Spain. There's a result, an interesting result in Spain that these communities are giving 16% rentability for shares for the people. So that means that poor people are discovering that they can be investors with these people. And they can invest in the community, and there's a high revenue of 60%. So that's more than the bank gives to you for your savings. And finally, I would like to say that it is this moment discovers that low-income people can be self-financed, first of all. You have to mobilize the money from the community, more than putting money from outside all the time. So first of all, mobilize the money in the community, so people discover that with their money, initially it's enough. It's a bit invasive and aggressive to put too much money in the community and creating too much debt to the people. It's self-managed, so I think low-income people prove that they can manage things, especially if they're in the community, with a good methodology, of course. You need a president, you need accounting, you need some skills, but I think low-income people can prove that they can manage them. And there's also high participation because it's their money. They own the company. They keep their shares. So that's all. We don't have much time. See you back here.
As you share with people your business model, because you set up these groups that are self-financing and self-governing, but your business model, what is the split of your revenues and where do you get it from?
Yes, more or less, it's our business model is 40% of our income comes from local governments that outsource us, they contract us, so that they, we create groups in the communities. So what is the local governments? 40% are companies. Companies that are interested in doing the study markets to study the needs of the people. And then 20% is self.